you will now. Now Katani, the Lang, Nakan, Po Nell, Lindemar, Wee Nan.
Life is good, John. Another year passed. How is it with you?
Getting along. Yes, I am.
Daniel.
Oh, John. Here's another quarter, I see.
Yes, I did.
Alexander.
Uncle.
Jack, how are you?
Hello, Nathaniel.
Yes, thank you.
Where's the traffic?
Why is Uncle so here? He should have settled with a woman and started a family by now.
Mohawk Field we saw was 5 miles long in the river. Chief Joseph Brand's field.
You take much fur?
That we did. Lots. And the hurricane's near trapped out now.
And where are you trading your skins, Castleton?
Zionville. Zionville. The Dutch for silver. French and English want to pay with wampum and brandy.
So what is it, Jack? What brings you here?
French and Indian Army are heading south out of Fort Caroline to war against the British. I'm helping to raise New York's militia to fill the Crown's levy.
Are the people here going to join in that fight?
We'll see in the morning. Where are you boys heading?
We'll trap over the fall. Winter in Kentucky. Find a Delaware-speaking woman for Uncas. She will say, you are the one. Bear him many children.
Can he have a boy like me?
Never. You're too strong. Turn me old too fast.
Oh, that's what he's doing to his mama.
Cameron, thank you for your hospitality. Mohawk traded furs with Le Francais. Got no coral with Le Francais. Now Le Francais bring Huron, Ottawa, Abenaki onto Mohawk land. Now Mohawk will fight Le Francais and Huron. I speak for the Twin River Mohawk of the Six Nations.
His Majesty King George II is very grateful for your support. How far up the valley?
Up to Fort William Henry.
That's two nights and a bit from you.
It should be enough to remind you all that France is our enemy.
That's your enemy.
What did you say? While we're at your fort, what if the French attack our homes?
What then, Lieutenant? For your homes, for king, for country. That's why you men ought to join this fight.
You do what you want with your own scalp. Then I'll be telling us what we ought to do with ours.
You call yourself a patriot and loyal subject to the crown?
Do not call myself subject to much at all.
I agree with some of what Nathaniel and John say. But I believe England's still our sovereign.
I'll go.
We're going to fight the French.
Brother and I will volunteer up.
I'll fight with you, Jack.
I'm staying on my farm. Any man who goes, his family's welcome to fort up with us till he comes back.
Boys, my sense of it is we have enough here to fill the county levy. And it's a fight we ought to make. But first, we got to get terms from General Webb.
What terms?
Where are you meeting?
We'll go to Albany.
Thank you.
We speak for the men, not command them. If they're not allowed leave to defend their farms and families, the French attack the settlements. The no colonial militia has gone to the Fort William Henry.
They will report or be pressed into service.
Any of the boys worth having can disappear into
the forest. They will be found.
And where does that leave you?
Those men will be found, arrested.
I cannot imagine His Majesty and his benevolence would ever object to his loyal American subjects defending their hearth and home, their women and children.
Does that mean they will be granted leave to defend their homes if the settlements are attacked?
Of course.
You got yourself a colonial militia, General.
Major Duncan Hayward reporting, sir, en route to Fort William Henry and bearing dispatches.
Safe journey, I trust?
Yes, and I didn't experience anything so surprising from Bristol to Albany as that I witnessed here today.
What's that?
The Crown negotiating the terms of service.
I know.
One has to reason with these colonials to get them to do anything.
Tiring, isn't it? But that's the lay of the land.
I thought British policies make the world England. Sir.
I see you're to serve with the 35th Regiment of Foot at Fort William Henry under Colonel Monroe. I'll be marching the 60th to Fort Edward.
Explain to the Major he has little to fear from this General Marquis de Montcalm in the first place, and therefore scant need of a colonial militia in the second, because the French haven't the nature for war. Their Latinate voluptuousness combines with their Gallic laziness, and the result is they'd rather eat and make love with their faces than fight.
Might I inquire if General Webb has heard from Colonel Monroe's daughters? I was to rendezvous with them in Albany and escort them to the fort, sir.
You there? What does Monroe call you? The Scotsman has sent you one of his Mohawk allies to guide you.
Magua.
The Scotsman's daughters are at the patroon's house. A company of the 60th will accompany you, and Magua will show you the way.
Dawn, at the encampment, 6 a.m. sharp. See to it you're there.
In Albany.
For days and days. And yourself?
Just arrived. By God, it's good to see you.
I don't know what to say, Duncan. I truly wish they did, but my feelings don't go beyond friendship. Don't you see?
Respect and friendship, isn't that a reasonable basis for a man and woman to be married? All else may grow in time.
Some say that's the way of it.
Some?
Cousin Eugenie and my father.
Well, then, Cora. In my heart, I know, once we're joined, we'll be the most marvelous couple in London. I'm certain of that. So why not let those whom you trust, your father, help settle what's best for you? In view of your indecision, you should rely on their judgment. And mine. Will you consider that? Please consider that.
Yes. Yes, I will.
Duncan!
My God, you've grown up.
We leave in the morning?
Yes, miss.
I shan't sleep tonight. What an adventure. Have you seen the regiment?
A few.
I absolutely cannot wait to return to Portman Square, having been to the wilderness.
Women are tired.
Now here, 2 leagues. Better water. We stop there.
No, stop in the glade just ahead. When the ladies are rested, we will proceed. Do you understand?
Magua rana go rado. It's run the rago. Isa ganrase. You nunque. Sin de cazada.
Excuse me, what did you say?
Magua said, understand English very well.
Thank you.
is any better in your judgment.
Your wound is to try walking on back to Albany. They'll never make a passage north.
Why is he loosing the horses?
Why don't you ask him?
Too easy to track. Can be heard for miles. We were headed to Fort William Henry.
Alumsituk, Wendetak.
Yo.
Shokis Shao, Katala Nashina.
Ayaska Katoch Walawana Katakanik Yawunj.
We'll take you as far as the fort. We're walking out of here fast.
Unless, Ollie, you'd rather wait for the next year on war party to come by.
I'd like to thank you for your help. How much further is it?
Night and a bit.
Fears we're well away from them?
Maybe. Maybe they ain't alone. That Huron captain back
the
there.
The guard is a Mohawk.
No Mohawk is Huron. No reason did he have to murder the girl.
What?
Dark-haired one.
Just called her Monroe. Murder her. You never set eyes on her before today. She's only been here a week.
Blood vengeance. Reproach or insult?
Of course not. How is it you were so nearby?
Came across the war party. Tracked him.
Then you're assigned to Fort William Henry?
No.
Fort Edward, then?
Heading west to Kentucky.
There is a war on. How is it you are heading west?
Well, we kind of faced to the north and real sudden-like turned left.
I thought all our colonial scouts were in the militia. The militia is fighting the French in the north.
I ain't your scout. I sure ain't no damn militia.
Ottawa, to Francais.
What did you say?
Mirrors. Tools. The clothes. Everything was inside. They didn't take anything.
They're moving fast. The war party.
Let us look after them.
Leave them.
Whoever they are, though they're strangers, they're at least entitled to a Christian burial. They cannot be left behind.
Let us go, miss.
I will not. I've seen the face of war before, sir, but I've not seen war made upon women and children. And almost as cruel as your indifference.
Miss Monroe. They're not strangers. And they stay as they lay.
Why didn't you bury those people?
Anyone looking for our trail would see it as a sign we'd pass that way.
You knew them well. You were acting for our benefit, and I apologize. I misunderstood you.
Well, that's to be expected. My father warned me
your
about...
Your father?
You. Chingachgook, he warned me about people like you.
Oh, he did?
He said, do not try to understand them. Yes, and do not try to make them understand you. That is because they are a breed apart and make no sense.
Did they turn back?
Burial ground.
Breed apart. We make no sense.
Your particular case, miss, I'd make allowance.
Thank you so much. Where's your real family?
They buried my mom, pa, and my sisters. Chingachgook family with two French trappers raised me up as his own.
I'm sorry.
I'd not remember. I wasn't but one or two.
How did you learn English?
My father sent Uncas and I to Reverend Wheelock's school when I was 10.
Why
were those people living in this defenseless place?
After 7 years indentured service in Virginia, they headed out here because Frontier is the only land available to poor people. Out here, they're beholden to none. Not living by another's leave. My name is Cameron. John Alexander Cameron. Father's people say that at the birth of the sun and of his brother the moon, their mother died. So the sun gave to the earth her body from which was to spring all life. And he drew forth from her breast the stars. The stars he threw into the night sky to remind him of her soul. So there's the Cameron's monument. My folks do, I guess.
You are right, Mr. Poe. We do not understand what is happening here. And it's not as I imagined it would be, thinking of it in Boston and London.
Sorry to disappoint you.
No, on the contrary. More deeply stirring to my blood than any imagining could possibly have been.
The next ridge, forts downhill of it.
The men of the regiment will fetch water from the lake, build fires, and provide every comfort you desire.
I cannot wait to see Papa.
Thank you.
Jeffrey Beams.
Didn't expect you'd make it through.
Let's cut the draft.
Couriers to Webb.
One's called Magwar arrived.
He delivered no such message.
Does Webb not even know we have a siege?
Sir, Webb has no idea. And he certainly does not know to send reinforcements.
What happened to you?
On the George Road. Attacked.
We're fine. Are you all right?
Yes.
What will happen here, Papa?
It'll be all right, girl.
This Magwar led us into it. 18 killed. These men came to our aid. They guided us here.
Thank you. Do you need anything?
Help ourselves to a few horns from your powder stores.
Need some food.
Indebted to you.
Miss Corder, how are you?
Hello, Mr. Phelps.
Mrs. McCann will get some dry clothes.
Thank you.
Go with your sister, Alice. It'll be all right, girl. It'll be all right.
Might I inquire after the situation, sir, given that I've seen the French engineering from the ridge above?
The situation is his guns are bigger than mine, and he has more of them. They keep our heads down while his troops dig 30 yards of trench a day. When those trenches are 200 yards from the fort and within range, he'll bring in these 15-inch mortars, lob explosive rounds over our walls, and pound us to dust.
They look to be 300 yards out. If they're digging 30 yards a day, you'll have 3 days.
Man here can make a run straight through to Webb.
3 days is not enough time to get to Albany and back with reinforcements.
Webb's not in Albany. He marched the 60th to Fort Edward 2 days ago.
Webb is at Edward?
Yes, sir.
That's only 12 miles away. He could have reinforcements here the day after tomorrow. You, sir, pick your man. Major Hayward will provide a diversion. I'll draft out a dispatch. Captain Beams will seek you out and give it to you later.
Something else. Cameron's cabin. Frontier cabin. Came upon it yesterday. It was burnt out. Everyone murdered. It was Ottawa, allied to the French.
Aye. So?
It was a war party. That means they're going to be attacking up and down the frontier.
Thank you, sir.
People here. Mohawks. Settlers have family out there.
That'll be all, sir.
Things were done. Nobody was spared.
Those considerations are subordinate to the interests of the Crown. A terrible feature of war here in the Americas, Major Hayward. Let's keep your eye fixed on our duty. To defeat France. That hangs on a courier to Webb.
my children are the children of the true faith. My friendship and esteem is boundless. Tomorrow, I will sing the war song with you at the great council fire. Magua, how are things with your English friends?
Do we not want? Join us.
Hear what Le Subtil has to tell us.
The English war chief Webb goes to Fort Edward with 60th Regiment.
He does not know that my father's army attacks Fort William Henry.
Magua was successful.
The other two couriers died in the forest.
By now, Monroe would know his dispatch did not get through. It's in another.
The gray hair will try.
4 or 5, including 2 women, entered the fort.
The gray hair's children were under Magua's knife. They escaped. They will be under it again.
Why do you hate the gray hair, Magua?
When the gray hair is dead, Magua will eat his heart. Before he dies, Magua will put his children under the knife so the gray hair will know his seed is wiped out forever.
My engineers are advancing the trenches through the night. You may have your opportunity soon.
Miss Corder. Gentlemen looking for you.
It's my role.
May I?
Proceed, and then it's going to draw.
Thank you, miss.
About done holding hands with Miss Monroe.
Got some work to do.
What are you looking at, sir?
I'm looking at you, miss.
Monroe refused to believe what happened.
He does not even want to hear it. He's going to have to.
Get together by the West Bastion. Ian, Sharatarish, Angawisgane, and William.
Tight weave.
Still, another 40 yards.
Thank you.
How am I to know it wasn't a raid by common thieves?
The cabin was attacked by a war party fighting with the French. They're sweeping south down the frontier, attacking farms and Mohawk villages. All the men are stuck here.
I need proof more convincing than this man's opinion before I weaken the fort's defenses by releasing the militia.
Chingachgook's of the same opinion about the raid. Taken together, that's gospel. Your fort will stand or fall dependent on Webb's reinforcements, not the presence of the colonials.
I judge military matters here, not you.
Your judgment is not more important than their right, under agreement with Webb to defend our farms and families. Major Haber was there. He was at John Cameron's. He saw what it was.
What exactly did you see, Major?
I saw nothing that would lead me to the conclusion it was other than a raid by savages bent on thievery.
You're a liar.
Major! Montcalm is a soldier and a gentleman, not a butcher.
Easy for you to suppose. It's their women and children alone on the farms, not yours.
You forget yourself, sir.
We're not forgetting Webb's promise.
British promises are honored, and the militia will not be released. Because I need more definite proof than this man's word.
Nathaniel's word's been good on this frontier a long time before you got here.
This meeting is over. The militia stays.
Does the rule of English law no longer govern? Has it been replaced by absolutism?
If English law cannot be trusted, maybe these people would do better making their own peace with the French.
That is sedition!
That is the truth.
I'll have you beaten from this fort.
Someday I think you and I are going to have a serious disagreement.
Anyone fomenting or advocating the leaving of Fort William Henry will be hung for sedition. Anyone actually caught leaving will be shot for desertion. And my decision is final. Get out.
Cora.
I wanted to talk to you.
Talk with Duncan, Cora. I must manage. I cannot be an invalid schoolgirl.
Alice.
I'll see if Mr. Phelps needs anything.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. Cora, when we come together back in England and are married and away from this place, what had to be done and said here will matter not at all. I'm certain of that.
Duncan, I promised you an answer. You've complimented me with your persistence and patience. But the decision I have come to is that I'd rather make the gravest of mistakes than to surrender my own judgment. Please take this as my final answer. It must be no.
I see.
Yeah, Nathaniel, but you weren't ever for being here.
That's right, I saw it that way then, I see it that way now. Yeah, and if I had kin in the settlements, hell be damn sure I'd be long gone.
What do we do about being under Crown law?
I believe if they set aside their law as and when they wish, their law no longer has rightful authority over us. All they have over us then is tyranny. And I will not live under that yoke. So I will stay here no longer. Anyone caught leaving the fort could be shot, so each man make your own decision. Those who are going be back in an hour.
Out the northern Sallyport. Strike for the east side of the swamp till you clear the French picket line. Head north over the ridge, then come about southeast. Forklift and Little Meadow near Freer the outpost and skirmishers.
Should have gone out of this long ago.
Got no families, Captain. Figured we'd stay and give a hand.
I'll cover you from the top of the bastion.
You're not coming with us?
I got a reason to stay.
That reason wear a striped skirt and work in the surgery.
It does.
No offense, but it's a better looking reason than you, Jack Winthrop. Push hard, because you've got to clear the French outpost by dawn. Good luck, Jack. Uncle Visconti, are you Stan?
Yes.
It's too many French.
And so few of us to fight, not too many to die. But we've given our word to our English fathers.
Stand off.
Take him.
Quickles. To me a wawa, the gusso.
The witch mao shwanak, what make a takanik with alamasinawa. As you were. No. Matanaki, kamata katamon. Katawawa. He walked the hunts.
Bishaha abiangwa, canuk the men shall fly. Quicket. Haweto? Najo. Wanik. Niguisus.
He saved us. We're alive only because of him.
The man encouraged the colonials to desert in this very room and in my presence. Sir, he is guilty of sedition. He must be tried and hanged like any other criminal, regardless of what he did for my children.
But he knew the consequences and he stayed. Are those the actions of a criminal? Duncan, do something.
he knew the penalty for his actions, he ought to pay without sending you to beg.
You know he wouldn't send me. You falsely spoke of what you saw. What happened at the farm was as Nathaniel said.
But not with enough certainty to outweigh British interests in this fort.
And who empowered these colonials to pass judgment on England's policies in her own possessions and to come and go without so much as a by your leave?
They do not live their lives by your leave. They hack it out of the wilderness with their own two hands, burying their children along the way.
You are defending him because you've become infatuated with him.
Duncan, you are a man with a few admirable qualities. But taken as a whole, I was wrong to have thought so highly of you.
Cora!
Cora, I would do anything I could to keep you from being hurt. But this man is guilty of sedition. And subject to military justice and beyond pardon.
Justice? If that's justice, then the sooner French guns blow the English army out of America, the better it will be for the people here.
You do not know what you're saying.
Yes, I do. I know exactly what I'm saying. And if it is sedition, then I am guilty of sedition too. Going to hang you. Why didn't you leave when you had the chance?
Because what I'm interested in is right here.
What can I do?
Webb's reinforcements will arrive or not. If they do not arrive, the fort will fall to the French. If that happens, stay close to your father. Stay close to him. The French officers will try to protect the officers among the English.
No. I will find you.
Do not. Promise me.
The whole world's on fire.
Thank you.
Lieutenant Monroe. I have known you as a gallant antagonist. I am happy to make your acquaintance as a friend.
And I yours, Monsieur le Marquis.
Please accept my compliments for the strong and skillful defense of your fortress. Under the command of a lesser man, it would have fallen long ago, given the superior numbers and materials. Chance has allowed me to array against you.
Monsieur le Marquis, I'm a soldier, not a diplomat. You call this parley for a better reason than an exchange of compliments.
You have already done everything which is necessary for the honor of your prince. But now I beg you to listen to the admonitions of humanity. I beg you to consider my terms for your surrender.
Perhaps the general's glass can reach as far as the Hudson and seize the size and imminence of the army of Webb.
My scouts intercepted this dispatch intended for you. Capitaine de Bougainville.
To Colonel Monroe. Sir, I regret to inform you that I have no men available to send to your rescue. It is quite impossible. I advise you to seek terms for surrender. I remain Jérôme Webb at Fort Edward.
This is the signature of Webb. And I know the temper of our men. Rather than spend the war in a French prison hulking Hudson Bay, they fight to the end.
You've heard your answer, Monsieur le Marquis.
Sir, I beg you not to sign the death warrant of so many until you have listened to what I have to say.
Go on.
None of your men will see the inside of a prison barge. They are free. So long as they return to England and fight no more on this continent, and the civilian militia return to their farms.
Their arms?
They may leave the fortress fully armed.
My colors?
Carry them to England with pride.
Allow me to consult with my officers. Live to see something which I never expected. A British officer afraid to support another.
Webb can burn in hell. And we'll go back and dig our graves behind those ramparts.
Death and honor are thought to be the same. But today I have learned that sometimes they are not.
Sir.
Monsieur le Marquis, I am deeply touched by such unusual and unexpected generosity. My fort is yours, under the condition that I be given till dawn to bury my dead, to prepare my men and women for the long journey ahead, and to hand my wounded over to your surgeons.
Granted, monsieur.
The hatchet buried between the English and my French father?
Yes.
Not a warrior has a scalp, and the white men become friends.
My master owned these lands, and I have been ordered to drive off the English squatters. They have consented to go. So now I call them enemies no longer.
Magua took the hatchet to color with blood. It's still bright. Only when it's red, then it will be buried.
So many suns have set since Magua struck the war post.
And where is that sun? Magua's the son of his people, and he has come to lead many of them.
But Magua has power with his Huron people, and others here, I know well.
Magua's village and lodges were burnt. Magua's children were killed by the English. I was taken a slave by the Mohawk who fought for the Grey Hair. Magua's wife believed he was dead and became the wife of another. The Grey Hair was the father of all that. In time, Magua became blood brother to the Mohawk to become free. But always in his heart, he is Huron. And his heart will be whole again on the day Gray Hair and all his seed are dead. Does the chief of the Canadas believe the English will keep the terms?
I fear, having let them go, which I must, I will only fight the same men again when I drive towards Albany. But I cannot break the term of the surrender and sully the lilies of France.
before you die, know that I will put under the knife your children, so I will wipe your seed from the earth forever.
going?
Nowhere.
I don't understand.
This is as far as we go. We're lucky they'll figure we beefed our canoes and headed across land. We're very lucky they'll figure we went over the fall.
Our only hope is that they pass us by.
If they do,
take the south rim down the mountain. 12 miles cross country to Fort Edward.
And if they don't?
We'll just have to forego the pleasure of hanging me. Hayakina, Paul Gasolina.
One more.
Haru.
Thank you.
Anna Yankees. Lieutenant, got up.
Γέρε, τι ήταν, σε οτόδο, ανεκό σας.
Σκουιστός ήταν οι γενγκείς το ζηλίου γάσασι. Ήταν οι δόγια, αν οι σκαϊτάνο δίνας λίγε. Ας γενιού η έστ. Καλή ατενόγε, αν οι ζωή, αν οι γενγκείς. Να σκαϊτζικ. Zindin, ni le français, uniwas, on a couillon de dégance. Tout l'anno, et ni taleha, Monroe, du wedge, y d'aide à gonsta, ni garde no j'en y go wata. Ni j'en liste, ou de l'esquignol.
Thank you.
what's tanner to yes, huh? Nigga's tanner.
Don't speak here, I'll speak French, Major. Oh. Yes. Translate for me into French every word as I say it. I come to you unarmed and in peace. To unstop your ears, Sachem. Let the children of the dead Colonel Monroe go free. Take fire out of the English anger over the murder of their helpless ones.
Les Anglais sur le meurtre de les impuissants s'apaisera.
Notre père manque quand même meilleur dans l'art de la guerre que les Yankees. Les Hurons n'ont pas peur de la colère des Anglais.
Sachem, the French fathers made peace. Magua broke it. It is false that the French will be friends still to the Hurons.
Tel Hurons, notre père français. Très content de ne jamais avoir se battre contre. Le même Yankees.
Jouer haut. Et te gagner, jouer haut. L'Anglais vient comme l'autre de Dieu. Et les nuits, tu amènes ce sang pour le futur. Notre conseil se pose la question de Bricard. Je suis un fan. Cordove. Les Hurons.
Les Français, au pour des Hurons. Et ça, c'est bien. Que là, les Hurons reconnaître sa force. Nous marchandrons que le blanc marchons. Le prendre terre. Prendre la terre des Abenaki. Et le pour des Osages, Sark, Fox. La faire commerce dans l'art avec les autres nations indiennes. Pas moi que les blancs, ni aussi fort que les blancs.
Would Magua use the ways of les Français and the Yengis? Would you?
Yes!
Would the Huron make his Algonquin brothers foolish with brandy and steal his lands to sell them for gold to the white man? Would Huron have greed for more land than a man can use? Would Huron fool Senegrin to take in all the furs of all the animals of the forest for beads and strong whiskey? Those are the ways of the Yengis and the Francais traders, and their masters in Europe infected with the sickness of greed. Magua is hard as twisted. He would make himself into what twisted him. I am Nathaniel of the Yengis, Hawkeye, adopted son of Chingachgook of the Mohican people. Let the children of the dead Monroe and the Yengis officer go free. This belt, which is a record of the days of my father's people, speaks for my truth.
Pour pas les poissons! Avec l'autre, l'on for sure!
Magua, Signor Taoute! Yes, a tati in the zone, ne aito a taita. Yes, a garo go home a tagahage. Just somewhat what you got in the Monroe. Dan Magwas, Ghana, I'm on the Tunyagi. Yankee, Sazoa Tundi, Dinuza Doa Teju. Monroe, Sagoya, Otu Quaga Yai. Dan Magwas, Ghana, I'm on the Tunyagi. Long Carby, Bam Pat.
Leave
her! Elle, give her the place! Prenez-moi! Pas pour faire un autre elle!
Alex!
Ce n'est pas le bois de la sagesse! Vous êtes au Huron de Lac! Vous êtes des femmes! Esclaves chiennes! Je crache à vous!
Stop it!
Arrêtez!
I am the Long Carabine! My death is a great honor to the Huron! Take me! Did you tell him?
Yes.
Yeah, she's right down.
Take me!
My compliments, sir! Take her and get out!
Duncan, what are they doing to Duncan? We're bad at it! Alex!
great spirit and the maker of all life. A warrior goes to you swift and straight as an arrow shot into the sun. Welcome him and let him take his place at the council fire of my people. He is Uncas, my son. Tell him to be patient and ask death for speed. For they are all there, but one. I, Tingitska, last of the Mohicans.